Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
My name is Christina Martinez. I'm a breeder and a breed mentor. I used to be the president for 4 years of the local club out here, but now I do everything with the parent club. The Rat Terrier purpose is to keep your property clean of all small vermin and to alert you to anybody, I guess, coming on your property. My Rat Terriers take care of the squirrels, the rabbits, the birds, the snakes. They are just an all-around vermin cleanup. Rattlesnakes, king snakes, any kind you find in Southern California we have here. Rat Terriers, what they'll do is they'll hunt, and they hunt and hunt and hunt. And when the snake goes to strike, they jump back or they jump up, and then you do it about two or three times, and as soon as they can catch on, they grab around their throat and just basically shake until the head comes off. I try to keep them away from like the king snakes because they keep the rattlers down, but we do have rattlesnakes here on the property too. Gopher snakes and, I mean, other things like that. They can take on, you know, just about almost anything. I mean, they're very fearless, so they don't really realize they're a small dog, but they think they're a big dog in a small dog's body. So Rat Terriers don't tend to even think size-wise. So even if you have a mini, they're still gonna go after something bigger, even if they can't take it down. That's why, I mean, I prefer the standards, because I have the coyotes out here. We have every kind of vermin you can even think of out here. And they do better in packs too. So, I mean, you don't ever want to send just one Rat Terrier out. They usually buddy up with another Rat Terrier and they'll go out and hunt together. So mine are all on the buddy system. I will never send one dog out by itself. So when I say a pack, you know, at least 4 to 5 will go out at nighttime. And if there's coyotes running loose, they will go and they will alert me that there's coyotes out there. And we usually bring them in or call the bigger dog out to go take care of them. I have a great Pyrenees, and that's what she protects the Rat Terriers. Rat Terriers are a warm, scented hunting dog. So they're not a hound. They can't go and find a scent after 3 days. If the scent is not there, they will not find it. So if a rat would run across in the barn here, they would be able to alert you and go after it. Breed standard goes from 10 inches at the shoulder to 18 at the shoulder. The minis are 10 to 13. Anything over from 13 to 18 is a standard. And weight never comes into play. We go by height. Actually, the Rat Terriers are from all over. I mean, they said they brought them over from England to kill the rats at the White House, if you've ever read that story. But they originated from every different breed that you can imagine, from the Staffordshire to the Manchester to the, I mean, every type of breed that's added into them from their family tree, until we actually came into AKC, and that's when they kind of, you know, stopped adding in different breeds of dogs. I mean, we've even had Basenji added in. It's not in the family tree, but we all know it was added in. I started with the minis, and then when I first moved out here over 20 years ago, I had a gopher problem, so I started doing my research. And when I went to a local breeder, all she was raising was minis. And so I'm thinking, well, this is not what I kind of wanted. So I started doing a lot more research, and I found the standards from another breeder, and I picked up my first standard, and he was about 18 inches at the shoulder, which is the top of the standard, and 40 pounds. I was like, wow, this is a Rat Terrier. I had a little teeny one and a huge one. And that's when I kind of got into breeding the dogs, because I wanted to take care of my property. I wanted to track with them, and the bigger ones can do all that. Well, when I go out riding my horses, I take them across the street. Not in the summertime, it's too many rattlesnakes, but you send them out in front of you to make sure there's nothing, you know, that you're gonna walk into, like, you know, a mountain lion, bobcat. We have all those out here too. So they're kind of scouting out for you. So what I call my dogs is, I call them hunting machines on the outside, but couch potatoes in the inside. They're like my all-around quarter horse. I can, you know, have them work here on my farm, or I can take them to into the ring, into confirmation, and they do perfectly. So you can do everything with the Rat Terrier. I don't know about the other terriers, but a Rat Terrier, I can have them here, or I can walk in the show ring with them. They're not really barkers. The Rat Terriers, outside of just the hunting, they excel in agility, rally obedience. They excel in, they're very personable dogs. So they don't think that they're a dog, they think they're a human. And so you always have to be one step ahead of a rat terrier or you're in trouble. They'll boss you around when you want to boss them. So that's just, they're just really highly intelligent. Well, if you read in the history books, they said it was from the Teddy Roosevelts, but those are now classified as type B. We are type A, which are the longer-legged dogs. We are a 50-50 breed. We're 50 from ground to elbow, elbow to shoulder. That makes our movement different. We move in a more briskly. We have kind of like a trotting horse would move, and a reach and drive. So we move off our shoulder, not our leg. And a lot of terriers will move off leg, not shoulder. So when you're seeing them move, the faster they build up speed, they don't have to actually pick up and run. They can actually pick up and go move faster and faster until they get their prey. Judges are most confused on our ears. The ears are supposed to be either upright, buttoned, or tipped. Well, when a dog walks in the ring with one up and one down, it says should be upright, buttoned, or tipped. But most people take that as it can be one up, one down. But we're not supposed to. We're supposed to have them all equally balanced, even on our ears. And that's another thing is the balance. People don't understand about the balance of the rat terrier. We are a balanced dog. We're not a fine bone dog. We are a moderate bone dog, and we're always balanced. Your black tri, your red sable, blues, chocolates, pearls. There's 9 colors. Any color or pattern is acceptable without preference except brindles and merles, which are a DQ. Preferred to have 10% white or more, but must have at least an inch of white. Speckling and ticking and modding is common, but heavily ticking is undesirable. Okay, we have sables in our breed, which are the Agati gene. A lot of people don't understand that. When a sable is born, they have the black around their eyes, their ears, and then they have the stripe going down their back, but as they grow, they lose that black. And so you'll see on the registry, it'd be red sable and white. Okay, but everybody's like, well, what's the sable? The sable is the Igotti, but you usually only see red and white because they've lost the black, the sabling. The life expectancy for rat terriers, you know, around 16 years of age. Rat terriers are generally a very healthy breed. I mean, there's very little that you, yes, we check for the patellas, and that would probably be our worst thing is a patella issue, but generally they're pretty healthy. We have PLL, PRA. We do now have a new test for CDDY, but that's more on your dwarfism dogs. And if the dog has short legs, and some rat terriers have shorter legs, then they should be classified as your teddies, but they've already been registered as rat terriers. So when we separated, some of the teddies went in with the rat terriers also. So you'll see some of the shorter legs, and which a lot of people don't show those. They'll go back to the teddies. So they were together at one point, the teddy bees and the rat terriers, and then they separated. So some of the teddy bees still got in with the rat terriers. A rat terrier would be a great dog if you're active. If you're not active, then it probably wouldn't be your best first pick for a dog, you know. But a rat terrier, you need to be active with them. It's just like any other puppy. You have to be on top of them all the time. Rat terriers, you have to keep their mind busy all the time and working. As long as they're working, they're happy. So you can't just, you know, get a rat terrier and keep it in an apartment per se. If you're not going to take it out, you know, running, walking, they have to have that mental and physically activity for you to have a rat terrier. For a rat terrier, a big yard, a fenced yard. I mean, they can scale your fence, but if they are bonded to their person, they will never leave you. So if I let my rat terriers out, my fence isn't that high. They could scale it if they wanted to, but they won't leave because they're happy. They're a very loyal dog, and that's something that you don't find in a lot of breeds. Rat terriers are loyal. They love their people. When I started crate training my rat terriers, because I'm going to show them, and you know you have to go on the road sometimes, I will generally start, you know, with a few hours at a time up until I can make it, you know, I don't like to, but I try to, when I'm traveling, you know, sometimes you have to have them in a car a long time or a motorhome. So generally, you know, 9-10 hours at the most and without having any mental stimulation. However, if they're like your house dogs, you leave a TV on or radio on, it keeps them stimulated because they're seeing, you know, different things. They're better in warm weather. They are a short, slick coat. So yes, they'll get a little bit of a winter coat, but the rat terriers generally do better in the warm weather. If you don't have warm weather, you better have, you know, either keep them in your home or have facilities that's going to keep them warm. Because they like to go under the covers, sleep with you. I mean, so they're very personable like that. Rat terriers tend to get a bad rap because of being yappity. They like to, some of them like to, you know, bite. But mine, you know, I don't allow that. But they should be protective also, you know. I mean, so it just depends on what you're using it for. But the old-time judges, like the older judges that do confirmation, they remember the rat terriers as good old farm dogs. You don't want your breeding males to be out with other, you know, generally breeding males, but they do get along, so that's no big deal. I just, you know, kind of separate females from males unless, if the females aren't in season, the males can be out with them. They're highly intelligent, but they're stubborn. So what you think may not be trainable is because you haven't worked with them to know. It's like they don't like to be punished. So on their punishing, if you act like you are punishing them, they'll kind of give you the finger and turn around and do what they want to do. If you get reinforce it, like positive reinforcement, they'll do whatever you want. So it's always positive reinforcement with the rat terriers. You scream, you yell, they're not going to do it. They're going to say, uh-uh, they're mad at me. So they already know. So positive reinforcement is the best way for these rat terriers. A terrier's a terrier, whether it's a rat terrier or a Staffordshire terrier or whatever kind of terrier, bull terrier. But rat terriers don't like their ears being grabbed. And so that's the first thing a child will do is try to grab for the ears, and then they back up. So if you're not raised around children, they don't like children. They don't like the shuffling, and they don't like the grabbing. So I teach, you know, like even my granddaughter, I teach her nice, let them smell you first before you start grabbing on the dogs, because they're going to be a terrier regardless. But personality-wise, there's no comparison. The rat terriers are... way up, I don't want to say way above, but they just have a different persona. They're not as scrappy. They're more of an elegant breed as the terriers go. The way I fell in love with the rat terriers is because I treat them as an all-around quarter horse. They can do anything from, like I said, sleeping in my bed to walking in the confirmation ring to go out tracking with me. And they hunt. So there's not too many dogs that can do everything like a quarter horse can. I've had horses all my life, and I barrel race with them. So I, you know, treat them like one of my horses. And I have a lot of dogs in the, you know, the confirmation world, of course. And, you know, same thing with rally, obedience, agility. I didn't get into the rat terriers thinking I was going to go in the confirmation ring either. I kind of got thrown into doing that, and I kind of liked it. So I, you know, continued doing confirmation. If you want to get a rat terrier, do your research, call around to different breeders. Make sure you go to a breeder that does health testing. There's a lot of breeders out there that say they do health testing, which is not true. So you want to make sure all your dots are dotted, your T's are crossed on, you know, going to a breeder to find your information. Even if a breeder's been breeding, say, for 30 years, if they don't do any testing, there's got to be something wrong with that picture. They're out there for the money. They're not out there for the breed. I mean, I've been breeding for quite a while, but I do the health testing. I do the different things that it takes to have the rat terriers, where there's other people who do it just for the money. And that's when you come in the temperament issues, because they're not socializing their puppies. They're not doing a lot of things. They're just having litter after litter after litter, instead of saying, hey, this is the, when somebody comes to me for a rat terrier puppy, I don't let them choose their rat terrier. I choose it for them. I ask them, what are they going to be doing with it? Is it going to be in the inside? Are you going to have it outside? Do you live in an apartment? Do you have a fenced yard? I mean, anything and everything I question about the people who are going to get my puppy, because I want to make sure that they're a fit. I don't want to have to take a dog back. And a lot of breeders take dogs back because they're selling. They don't even know their dog's personality. I know each and every dog's personality when I sell a dog. And I fit the dog to the people, not the other way around.